Hi, this is Lewis from Gold Plating Services. I'm here again with Rob to show you some new tips and ideas. Today we're looking at stainless steel and chrome. When polished, they kind of look, well, no, not kind of, they look exactly the same. So we're going to show you how to differentiate between them. And then we're also going to gold plate some chrome for you. So we pulled out one of our little beaker trays that we sell and put a few extra solutions in there. And Rob's going to show you how to tell the difference, and then he'll plate a little bit onto the stainless steel for you.
All right, thanks, Lewis. All right, so this is a really common question when it comes to automotive plating. Commonly called eyebrow trim, which is over the wheels, will be stainless steel. Window trim as well is frequently stainless steel, and the ones around the headlights. If you try and strip stainless steel, it doesn't work, obviously. And so I'm going to show you just a few tips and like what happens if you try and what's the best way to proceed. So this is not polished. This is a matte piece of stainless steel, but doesn't make a difference. We'll get the point. What you do, if you're not sure, put it into stripping mode and just go ahead and try and strip it. See what happens. What you're looking for is if it's chrome, if you've ever done chrome, it will turn a yellow, your sleeve turns yellow, all the solution turns yellow, and the piece starts to turn a bronze tan color. As you can see here, nothing is happening except bubbling. And so that right there immediately would tell me, okay, this item is not chrome, because if it were, it would be turning yellow and stripping. I'm going to show you now what happens if it is chrome, just in case you were wondering. This is just a regular wrench, and there's something perfect to practice on, by the way. And I always tell people to practice as much as possible before you do it on a customer's car or your own. As you can see here, it's quickly turning a bright yellow color, and you may or may not be able to see, but the piece actually turns a bronze color, and what that is that's the underlying nickel. Now, some types of nickel aren't as bronzy as this one is. This one's particularly obvious, but yeah, that's a good indicator. You see the solution turn yellow, turn a bronze color, you proceed with the stripping chrome steps. Now, we have a lot of videos showing that, and we're going to put a link below to where you can go see it. To keep this video short, we're going to move on to stainless steel. So now you've determined that the item is indeed stainless steel. The question then becomes, what do you do? What you do is you put your machine into normal plating mode, and as soon as you do that, this first solution that was chrome stripper now effectively becomes electro cleaner, which is the first step when you're plating on the stainless steel. You keep it at 7 volts for these first two steps. What we need to do before we move on, because we're not going to be using the activator, is we're going to switch out this thumb screw here. We're going to undo it, leave the bit in that activator, and we're going to hook up the Woods Nickel Strike. Now, this is Woods Nickel Strike, and it's only used for stainless steel and steel. It's basically an activator for those two solutions. Before we do that, we want to electroclean. You electroclean basically the same exact way you strip chrome. You know, same amount of time. You need to make sure that it's well electroclean, because if you don't, you're going to be sorry when the gold doesn't stick. This is by far the most important step. All of them are important, but you got to make sure it's well electrocleaned or nothing else works. Then you move on to the Woods Nickel Strike. You do the Woods Nickel Strike about the same as you do activator. Just quickly, a couple seconds per square inch, get everywhere. Rinse. Clip fell off here. Now I'm going to turn the voltage down a little bit so that we don't get burning. Some people can keep the voltage really high and not get burning. It's more of a skill thing. As you see, there goes the gold flying on there. See, if I hadn't electro cleaned it well or struck it properly, it would, the gold just doesn't go on fast at all. You get it to deposit, but it doesn't fly on like that to where, see, this is already gold plated. If I rinse it off, it looks good. If you're doing a door handle or something, you definitely would want to put on the gold for maybe a couple minutes. Just, I'd spend maybe 2 minutes in that area, and that'd be so thick it wouldn't wear off for a long time. But as you can see, it's got a nice gold plate on it. If you guys have any specific questions about this or something didn't make sense, just please comment below. You can always email or give us a call. And again, this is the Universal Plater Chrome Edition. And this right here, you maybe have never seen in a video before. This is our auxiliary beaker tray. And it's for this exact situation where you've maybe got other chemicals that you want to work with, but you don't want to have to take them in and out and all that stuff. It's pretty convenient. All this stuff can be found on our website. If you have any questions, give us a call, comment below, and thanks for watching.